Hi everyone, welcome and thanks for tuning in. Today, I want to share a story about a patient who came to me with a condition that isn't widely talked about, but can be life-changing and even life-threatening. It's a heart condition that can often go undetected and affects people of all ages. Let's dive in. Recently, I saw a 43-year-old man who came in with a specific complaint. He told me he often feels short of breath whenever he climbs stairs or go up a hill. This breathlessness started to concern him, so he came to me for evaluation. But before I continue with his story, I want to share a very personal experience from my medical school days, an event that showed me just how sudden and unexpected heart problems can be. When I was in medical school, I lived outside the campus, close to the teaching hospital. One day, I had a knock on my door. When I opened it, I found my neighbor's wife visibly distressed, telling me that her husband had just collapsed. I rushed with her to the apartment, and there he was, lying on the floor, unresponsive. I immediately started cardiopulmonary resuscitation, which is CPR. CPR is actually a life-saving technique we use in emergencies when someone's heart has stopped beating. I also asked her to inform the other neighbors to get a car ready so we could rush him to the hospital. A few minutes later, we were on our way, but I continued CPR in the back seat as we drove. But when we reached the hospital, the doctor at the emergency unit examined him and pronounced him dead. It was a heartbreaking moment for us. His wife was inconsolable because here was a healthy, active man in his mid-30s with no apparent signs of illness. His wife told me he had been working on his laptop in the sitting room, went to the bedroom to pick something up, and on his way back, he just collapsed. Later, an autopsy revealed the cause of his sudden death, and it was something that caught all of us by surprise. Stay to the end of this video to find out what took his life. Let's return to my recent patient who was experiencing breathlessness and came for evaluation. One of the investigations that was performed for him was an echocardiogram, or echo for short. An echo is a procedure where we use ultrasound waves to create images of the heart, helping us see how well it is pumping and if there is anything unusual. Let's go to the ultrasound machine so I can show you what I found for this patient. This is one of the images we get when we do an echo. Now, this isn't the image of the patient we are talking about, but rather that of a 26-year-old footballer who came in for a routine checkup. Let's take a moment to understand what we are looking at here. In this view, the heart is actually inverted, and as you can see, there are four chambers of the heart here. The lower ones here are called the atria, and the upper ones are called the ventricles. So, this is the right atrium, and this is the left atrium. Also, this is the right ventricle, and this is the left ventricle. Now, let me explain how blood flows within the heart. Blood from all parts of the body enter this chamber, that is the right atrium. From here, it is pumped to this chamber, the right ventricle. The job of the right ventricle is to pump the blood to the lungs, where oxygen is added to the blood. This oxygenated blood then moves back to the heart. It moves into this chamber, the left atrium, which then sends the blood to the final chamber here, the left ventricle. This is actually the strongest and most important chamber of the heart. The left ventricle has the crucial task of pumping oxygen-rich blood to the entire body. Most heart problems or diseases involve issues with the left ventricle, which is why it is so important to assess its function during an echo.
Another image we usually take of the heart during an echo is called the parasternal long axis view. Let me show you how it looks. This view focuses mainly on the left part of the heart. Here we see the left ventricle, the left atrium, and the aortic valve here, which allows blood to flow from the heart into the aorta and to the rest of the body. Now that you have an idea of what a normal heart looks like, let me show you the heart of my patients so you can compare them for yourselves. Now, here is the echo of my patient. Can you notice the difference? The walls of his heart are much thicker than normal, or as compared to the normal patient. This usual unthickening is a sign of a condition that makes it harder for his heart to pump blood effectively. Some people say bigger is better, but in this case, bigger isn't better. In fact, this heart is very sick. I'm sure you can spot the difference in both the parasternal view here and the four chamber view here. Unfortunately, this is the same condition that caused my neighbor's sudden death many years ago. After the autopsy, we learned he had hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, or HCM for short, which can sometimes remain hidden until it's too late. It's a condition where the heart muscle thickens, just like in my patients here, making it difficult for the heart to pump blood properly. HCM is the most common cause of sudden death in young athletes, often going undiagnosed. It can lead to symptoms like breathlessness, chest pain, fainting, and in some cases, like in my neighbor, sudden death. Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is a long name, so let's break it down into five parts. First, we have hyper, then trophic, cardio, myo, and pathy. Each part has a specific meaning rooted in Greek, and when we put them together, it all makes sense. First, we have hyper, which means excessive or too much. This tells us that something is beyond normal level. Next is trophic, which means or refers to growth. So when you combine it with hyper, it means excessive growth. Then we have cardio, from the Greek word cardia, meaning heart. This makes it clear that we are talking about the heart. Next is myo, which means muscle in Greek. In this case, we are specifically referring to the heart muscle. Then finally, we have pathy, from the Greek word pathos, meaning disease or disorder. So pathy tells us that there is an abnormal condition or problem. Now, when we put all these parts together, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy simply means an abnormal condition where the heart muscle is thicker than normal. The scariest thing about HCM is that while some people experience symptoms like my patient did, many others can have no symptoms until death strikes. Imagine going through life with no warning signs, feeling fine, even fit, and then suddenly, without any indication, the heart gives way. This is what makes HCM so dangerous. It can hurt quietly, even in apparently healthy people, until it's too late. In part 2, we'll dive into stories of famous people affected by HCM and discuss how this condition can be detected and managed. We'll also explore causes, symptoms, prevention, and treatment options. HCM is a condition that can affect anyone, even those without symptoms. If you or someone you know is involved in sports, has a family history of heart issues, or just wants to understand how to keep the heart healthy, you won't want to miss this. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you'll be the first to know when the next video goes live. It could help you or someone you care about detect a silent condition before it's too late. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Thank you.